Australopithecus sediba, another celebrity fossil. So what is so important about this species that it made it to the list of the celebrity fossils? Well, fossils of this species were so complete that scientists can see how entire skeletons looked like near the time when Homo evolved. The word sediba means fountain or wellspring in the Sesotho language. This species has scientists hotly debating its validity as a species and its relationships to other hominins, in particular its relationship to our genus Homo. Details of the teeth, the length of the arms and legs, and the narrow upper chest resemble earlier Australopithecus, while other tooth traits and the broad lower chest resembles humans. This species is definitely a celebrity fossil because it may give us a lot of information on the origin of the genus Homo. Even the skull has several derived features, such as relatively small premolars and molars, and facial features that are more similar to those in Homo. Its features are more derived than those of Australopithecus animensis and Australopithecus afarensis, but the traits that Australopithecus sediba shares with Homo may indicate a closer relationship between this species and Homo than between other Australopithecines and Homo. This species lived between 1.97 to 1.98 million years ago. Fossils were first discovered on the 15th of August 2008 by Matthew Berger, a 9-year-old son of Lee Berger, at the site of Malapa, South Africa, and was announced in 2010. The remains belonged to a male hominin that was labeled Malapa hominin 1, also known as MH1, but was more commonly known as Karabo, a nickname meaning the answer given by the Malapa people of the region. Other fossils, including an adult male and a female, were also found. The fossils were so complete that scientists can see how entire skeletons looked like near the time when Homo evolved. These links indicate that Australopithecus sediba may reveal information about the origins and ancestor of the genus Homo. Using the size of the remains to estimate height, Malapa hominin 1 was thought to have stood approximately 1.3 meters or about 4.25 feet tall. Changes in the pelvis to aid in bipedal walking occurred before other changes in the body that are found in later specimens of Homo. However, despite these changes in the pelvis and skull, other parts of Australopithecus sediba skeleton shows a body similar to that of other Australopithecines, with long upper limbs and a small cranial capacity with the size of 440 cubic centimeters. The fossils also show that changes in the pelvis and the dentition occurred before changes in limb proportions or cranial capacity. However, their bipedal movement was a little bit different from us, as with each step, Australopithecus sediba turned its foot inward with its weight focused on the outer edge of the foot. This may mean that upright walking evolved on more than one path during human evolution. Mostly found in Malapa, Southern Africa, the habitat of this species is thought to have been a mosaic environment of wood and grasslands. Although fossilized particles of plant tissue found from their tooth enamel indicate they may have had access to forest products. The mosaic of human-like and ape-like characteristics displayed by Australopithecus sediba was unlike any other known hominin. Due to the mixture of derived features in the pelvis and primitive features in other areas of the skeleton, it is unclear to some researchers the extent to which Australopithecus sediba used arboreal habitats or remained on the ground using terrestrial bipedal locomotion. Some paleoanthropologists claimed that Australopithecus sediba may be a better candidate as a direct ancestor of Homo erectus. In contrast, other paleoanthropologists hypothesized that Australopithecus sediba may have been part of Australopithecus africanus or existed concurrently with the true direct ancestors of Homo erectus. So what are your thoughts on this? Let me know in the comments section down below. Thanks for watching, and for more videos like these, check our channel out, as we have made many just for you. Continue to give us your love and support by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. This is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.